scientists found a way to travel faster than light. Spaceships capable of warp speed travel might seem like something out of a science fiction novel, but one leading scientist says it's not impossible. Dr. Erik Lentz recently published a report outlining a method by which a rocket might hypothetically travel faster than light, or more than 186,000 miles per second. Colonizing other planets in the galaxy would only take a few years if astronauts could travel that fast. The closest star to the Sun, Proxima Centauri, would take about 6,300 years to travel with today's rocket technology. Although the concept of warp drives has been floated before, most proposed devices violate known physical laws. The reason being, nothing can travel faster than the speed of light, as predicted by Einstein's general theory of relativity. However, Dr. Lentz, a scientist at Germany's Göttingen University, claims his made-up warp drive would be physically feasible. His solution uses a new theoretical particle to avoid the need for exotic ideas like negative energy, which are used by competing theories. Concepts for spaceships based on the assumed morphologies of several warp bubbles. A new statement from Göttingen University claims that ultra-fast solitons can move at any speed while still adhering to the laws of physics. Often called a warp bubble, a soliton is a type of compact wave that behaves like a particle by keeping its shape and traveling at a steady speed. According to Dr. Lentz, he came up with his theory by analyzing the literature and identifying blind spots in the investigation of warp drive. He thinks solitons can create conducting plasma and classical electromagnetic fields that can move faster than light. Both of these ideas are consistent with Einstein's theory of relativity and are well known within the framework of classical physics. His warp drive offers the tantalizing prospect of faster than light travel, but it is currently only a concept. The quantity of energy needed to run the device is simply not feasible with today's technology. Dr. Lentz indicated that in order to be feasible for current nuclear fission reactors, the energy savings would need to be roughly 30 orders of magnitude. Many energy-saving strategies have been presented in previous studies, and if implemented, they have the potential to reduce the required energy by over 60 orders of magnitude. According to Dr. Lentz, his hypothetical warp drive would not violate any physical laws. The astrophysicist has stated that he will be putting his efforts into developing a functional prototype of the device. Our effort has taken the problem of faster-than-light travel one step away from theoretical research in fundamental physics and closer to engineering, Dr. Lentz added. Now we have to find out how to get that staggering quantity of energy down to something that can be produced by something like a large modern nuclear fission power station. When that's done, we can start discussing making working models. So, is it possible for an object to move faster than light? In 1676, Danish astronomer Ole Rømer determined that the speed of light is finite after analyzing the orbit of Jupiter's moon Io. The American Museum of Natural History in New York City reports that 2 years after Rømer's work, Dutch mathematician and physicist Christian Huygens made the first effort to calculate the true speed of light. Light travels at an astounding speed, as demonstrated by Huygens' calculation of 131,000 miles per second, or 211,000 kilometers per second. This is not correct by modern standards, as we now know that the speed of light in the vacuum of empty space is roughly 186,282 miles per second. According to Albert Einstein's special theory of relativity, in a vacuum, nothing can travel faster than the speed of light. We cannot move through the fabric of space faster than the speed of light, said Jason Cassabry, an associate professor of aerospace engineering at the Propulsion Research Center, University of Alabama. Do I have your answer? On second thought, maybe not. Does the principle still hold if light is not contained in a vacuum? A theoretical physicist from Imperial College London, Claudia de Rem, told Live Science in an email that, technically, the statement nothing can travel faster than the speed of light isn't quite correct by itself, at least in a non-vacuum context. But she did point out a few important qualifiers. Because of its particle and wave-like properties, light may be thought of in two ways, as a particle, also a photon, and as a wave. The concept of wave-particle duality describes this phenomenon. If we consider light to be a wave, then there are multiple reasons why some waves can propagate across a medium quicker than white or colorless light. Because as light travels through a medium, for example, glass or water droplets, the different frequencies or colors of light travel at different speeds, she explained. According to a blog article by the University of Wisconsin-Madison, the longest and fastest red wavelengths are located at the top of a rainbow, while the shortest and slowest violet wavelengths are located at the bottom. Nevertheless, this is not the case for light in a vacuum. All forms of visible light travel at the same rate in a vacuum, 3 times 108 meters per second, since they are all electromagnetic waves. This means that radio waves and gamma rays travel at the same speed. Rhett Elaine, a physics professor at Southeastern Louisiana University, told Live Science in an email. According to DeRam, the only thing that can travel faster than light is light itself. However, this is only true outside of space's vacuum. It is important to note that the speed of light will always increase by 186,282 miles per second, regardless of the medium in which it is traveling. But there is something else to take into account when talking about things moving faster than the speed of light, as Cassabri argues. Since space-time is expanding, there are regions of the universe that are receding from us at a rate greater than the speed of light, he explained. Recently, light from a faraway star called Arendelle, which is 12.9 billion years old, was observed by the Hubble Space Telescope. But due to the overall expansion of the universe, Arendelle has been receding from Earth ever since it formed, and it is now 28 billion light years away. Even though space-time is speeding up, the material within it still moves at or below the speed of light. Hence, it is evident that nothing known to us travels faster than light. But is there any circumstance in which this would be possible? According to DeRam, built under the principle that the notions of space and time are relative, Einstein's special and following general relativity theories are based on this data. What does this imply? Someone who could travel faster than light with knowledge would have a warped sense of time compared to us, as stated by DeRam. Future events could have consequences in the present, and if that happened, reality as we know it would collapse. This suggests that it's probably not a good idea to give humans the ability to travel faster than light. But is there any chance of that happening? Do we anticipate a time when we will have the technological wherewithal to build spaceships capable of traveling at speeds greater than the speed of light, carrying cargo, and eventually human beings across interstellar distances? For faster-than-light travel, theorists have proposed various types of warp bubbles, as stated by Cassabri during her research. What does DeRam believe? We may envision communicating with systems beyond our solar system at the speed of light, as DeRam put it. Yet it's obviously impossible to send actual people traveling at the speed of light because we can't accelerate ourselves to that velocity. She went on to say that even in the ideal scenario, even if we imagine we could keep accelerating ourselves at a constant rate, we still wouldn't be able to match the speed of light because we wouldn't have the ability to do so. The closest we came was not quite enough. As it turns out, Cassabri is right about this. Ignoring relativity, it would take a year to approach the speed of light if you were to accelerate at a pace of 1g, which is Earth's gravity. Yet, you could only achieve that speed if your mass energy increases to the point of infinity as you approach light speed. Like Cassabri, Elaine is convinced that traveling at the speed of light is extremely improbable. But he also points out that doing so might not be required if humanity is to explore the furthest reaches of the galaxy. Using a wormhole in space is the only way we could comprehend traveling faster than light, Elaine added. We wouldn't be able to travel faster than light, but we might be able to go to another part of space more quickly. Thanks for watching.